people of Osun Central Senatorial District. The first and foremost, I think it's good that we are debating, I mean, this debate, this budget at this time. And to start with, the 2019 budget that was referred to has not possibly been implemented, would not have been implemented if budget is being passed at the close of a session of the National Assembly. Be that as it may, what struck me looking at the budget is that the country, contrary to the widespread impression that we have, is really a very poor country. And that if we are still thinking in a conventional way, we may not really be on the path of development. And I say this because looking at the budget itself, and traditionally our budget in Nigeria, there appear to be asymmetric relationship between revenue generation and expenditure in the budget. This clearly was stated in paragraph 21 of the budget speech by Mr. President, where it was highlighted that about 70% of budget deficit in the under the 2019 budget. And even under this particular budget, it's already been highlighted that 2.18 trillion naira will be the deficit under the budget. A lot of people out there will be talking of what was allocated to health, what has been allocated to education, what has been allocated to infrastructure. The question is that there is a difference between allocating money as head of expenditure and having the necessary revenue to be able to back up such issue. So I would rather say that as going forward, we must begin to think, how do we diversify revenue base of our society? When you talk about 256 billion being allocated to works, I have it on good authority that what is even required to take care of outstanding in the Ministry of Works and Housing is in excess of 500 billion naira. And here we have allocated 256 billion, I will be said to be huge, comparative to what has been allocated to other sectors. So I would say, one, there's a need for us to think outside the box in terms of how do we generate revenue for our country. One good step that has been taken in the budget in this regard is the increment of the percentage of VAT. And the good thing about this is that it is done having in mind the need to, for us to be able to think in the way of progressive taxation. When we look at the way the finance bill that has been sent has been couched from the speech of Mr. President, the vulnerable people, the poor people in the society, are being insulated from the effects of the increment of the VAT. Let the rich, the affluent, who can pay, let them pay for the development of our society. People say we go to other countries. They say everything go and run very well. It runs very well because everybody in that society, particularly the rich and the affluent, they pay for development of our society. In Nigeria, we must make our rich people to also pay for the development of our people. In the area of sectoral intervention, I want to commend the allocation to the power sector of 125 billion naira. But beyond the allocation, we must look at the legal and commercial constraints to ensure that there is effective transmission and distribution of electricity in Nigeria. We cannot talk about diversification of our economy when we run on less than 3 hours electricity in Nigeria. No meaningful economic development can occur. There cannot be diversification of our economy unless we take the issue of power, the issue of energy very seriously. So I want to enjoin us as we are considering this budget to also look at the legal and commercial constraints and re-examine what has been done, and if it is possible, undone what has been done in terms of ensuring that we have power, uninterrupted electricity in our country in no time. Without this, we cannot have any meaningful development. Thank you.
Page 268. Page 269.